Hey guys, Reverend Dave down here at Max Machine Works, standing here with Aaron. We said we were going to answer some tech questions, and we figured the best way to do that was on the video, right? Well, you love videos.
Sure.
All right, so from Singleton, if you have a stock Bravo X, what would be the first upgrade Max Machine Works would recommend?
On a stock Bravo X, I'd probably recommend the clutch shaft and the cage gear bearings and the rigid shim pack behind the upper pinion gear, because you're going to replace one of the weakest links in the drive by replacing the clutch shaft, and the cage gear bearings and the rigid shim pack, which we will show in a future episode, keep the gears in place so your backlash doesn't change. That way your gears stay set where they should and you got the strongest shaft in your upper.
Okay, so part two of that question comes from Farmo83, and it says, you know, first we should upgrade X, and we just said you're going to go with the vertical shaft, shim pack, and bearings. What would be the second and third thing you would upgrade?
I would probably go with the top cap with the bigger clutch shaft bearing, and I'd probably go,
kind of hard, right?
There's, you know, when we're building anything for big power, we're going to use the straight cut XR gear set.
Okay. So this one comes from Boatman 2. It says, where on a drive with a 4-blade versus 5-blade? And it says, does babying out of a hole really save time on your drive?
You know, there's a couple different thoughts on that. You know, the longer it takes you to get on plane, the harder it is on your drive because it's being loaded the whole time. I wouldn't baby it, but I wouldn't, you know, you'd never hammer the throttle down. Give it enough throttle to get it up on plane, go from there. We can also help that with a couple of the different cap plates we have, which make a big difference on a lot of boats.
Yeah, they'll cut your plane times in about half, right?
Yeah.
All right, from the same guy, from Boatman, oil lubrication on a 800 horsepower drive, 10 hours, 15 hours, 20 hours?
10 to 15. I'd probably change it at 10 the first time and see what it looks like. You know, the oil always doesn't look burnt, but the viscosity gets crushed down between the teeth of the gears, so it's good to get it out of there at 10 and see what it looks like. 15 tops, but I probably wouldn't go too much longer than that.
Okay, last part of that question, do you guys have a drive oil you recommend?
Yeah, there's several oils we use. The main one is a mix that we do, where we add an additive to it, gives a little bit more pressure resistance between the teeth. AMSOIL Severe Gear is good. The new Merck High Performance Brown is good. We run Allison Pro Gear 21 Type 3 7590 with an additive.
Okay. From Pallet Boy, do all these mods make the gears last longer? In short, if you build a drive up, will it make the gears last longer? And if so, how?
Yes, it does make the gears last longer. One of the big things in a Bravo is the gears move around inside the case and the backlash can change. When the backlash isn't right, it breaks a tooth. A lot of our pieces support the gears better so they don't move and the backlash stays the same the whole time, and then combined with the torsional ability of our shafting also takes some load off the gear set. You put all those together and it definitely makes the gears handle more power and last longer.
So by torsion, guys, he's saying the shafts will actually twist a little bit like a spring, so when you're engaging them, it's not a complete and total shock load and a hammer every time. It actually gives a little bit, right?
A little bit.
All right. That pretty much sums up our questions from last week. I hope you guys are enjoying the video. Thanks, Aaron, so much for doing these with us.
Thank you.
I know everybody's really enjoying it. That's it.